What's up guys, DeckerCrafter here, and I'm going to show you how to make a Cobblemon server because they just dropped an update adding over 200 new Pokemon and a ton of features. It's super cool, but I don't want to waste any of your time. Let's go ahead and install it and then also set up a server so that we can play it with our friends. There's going to be two things that you have to do in order to play it with your friends. First is going to have to have Java installed, so if you go to the Java downloads in the description, go to JDK 17 here, and then if you scroll down, you'll see Windows here, and you can click that, and then go to the Windows 64 installer, this download here. Once you've got that installed, you're ready to set up your Minecraft server. Alright, once you're on the Cobblemon website, you're just going to scroll down until you see the first download here underneath the new update notice. Hit download. And you're going to see right here, there's a Fabric release for 1.2.1. The reason we're going to use Fabric over Forge is it's a lot more optimized, and it'll be better for you and your friends. You're just going to click on that, the version 1.4 for version 1.2 of Fabric 1.2. Alright, once it downloads, you're just going to click up here, right click the file and hit show in folder. After you've done that, right click down here on the folder and hit file explorer. Now that this is open, we want to go to this PC, choose a hard drive, right click in an empty space, new folder. I'm going to title this folder Cobblemon server, and we're going to open it up here, drag Cobblemon into here. Now, we're going to take this Cobblemon server folder and just minimize it for the time being. We want to go back here and click Downloads again. And then we're going to scroll down to the Installation section. And we're going to right-click and open Fabric Loader in a new tab and Fabric API in a new tab. Fabric API you can just straight download if you click the download right down here. Whoop. But you want to make sure you get the 121, not the 122. Then you're going to... that's perfect. Hit Download. Same thing, show in folder, and we're just going to throw it in our Cobblemon folder. Now if we open up the Fabric Loader page, we're actually going to get download, and then we're going to need both of these because we're both installing it for our client and we're creating a server. So we can actually just hit download for Windows here and hit keep, and then down here we can see the Minecraft server download. Click on that. Make sure you change this to 121 right here. And then hit executable server jar. We're going to hit keep, show in folder. Of course, we're going to take the Fabric server, whatever, drag it in here. We're actually going to create a new folder, call it mods. And we're going to take Cobblemon and the Fabric API and drag them in there. Now what we want to do is actually rename this Fabric server MC to just server. Make sure it stays a jar file, if not, add .jar at the end of the file name, like that. Then we're going to create a new text document. We're going to title it run. Open it up. Java XMS 1G XMX 6G. So what we're doing is setting the minimum, the starting amount, XMS, to 1 gig of RAM, and the maximum our server can use to 6 gigs of RAM. Now we need to look for the jar file, server.jar, and we want no GUI. Then what we're going to do is go to File, Save As, Run.bat, and hit Save. You can delete the text document, run this file that we just created, and it's going to download your server stuff. While it does that, let's go ahead and go back to our downloads to the Fabric installer. Make sure we set the client to be the Minecraft 1.2.1. And then just hit install. Okay, so now we're going to see that we have this message that it requires we need Fabric API for most mods, which obviously we already know that. Just hit OK, and then close out of here. Now, our Cobblemon server is going to look a little bit different. You'll notice the black window closed, and we've got some new folders and files in here. We're going to open up this one called EULA, and change this to true, and then hit save. Don't change anything in your server properties file, but there is some things you can change. Just don't change the IP spot or the port spot. You don't need to. But you can look in there if you want. It's not relevant though to making this server. Now if we go in here, we can see that we have both of these. We're actually just going to copy these files. You can right click and copy or control C. We are going to launch Minecraft. Now there's one thing that you absolutely have to do before your friends are going to be capable of joining your server. I'm going to show you how you join your server, but for your friends to join, you're going to have to go and port forward. If you've never port forwarded before or you don't know how, I do have a tutorial for that in the description. You can go ahead and watch that after. When you launch Minecraft, you'll probably see the Fabric Loader here. If not, just click the little drop down and try to find it. We're going to go to Installations and click on the little folder icon. Now we're going to open up mods. Once we've got the mods folder open, we're going to paste in those two Cobblemon and Fabric API. And then we can close out of that. Now we can go back to play, hit play. I understand, hit play. Go back to your server folder and hit run. Now it's going to load up the server in here. This window is quite literally the server. So if you close it, your server is going to be down. All right, as you can see, the server says done and we've got Minecraft open now. So what we want to do in here is actually we can type in commands. So if we want to op ourselves, we type op space DeckerCrafter, made DeckerCrafter a server operator. You can ban people from here, whatever. If you type help, you can see the list of commands. Don't use the slash when you're using the commands from the console. Now if we go into multiplayer, we're going to hit add server and name it whatever you want. Then for the IP, you're just going to put a 0. Or you can type in localhost. Either one works. Your friends need your public IP, which you can get from canyouseeme.org, but you do have to port forward for it to work. You can join regardless of port forwarding, so if we hit done, hit join, and now you can enjoy the brand new Cobblemon update. Also, if you can't port forward or you don't want to host your own server on your computer, you can pay for a super cheap server host. I personally use Shockbyte, and you can save 25% with code DeckerCrafter. I'll see you guys in the next one. Adios.